As tensions rise between China and the West, particularly over Taiwan, the comparison between China's J-20 and the U.S. F-22 becomes crucial. While the J-20 edges out in some performance metrics, the F-22's proven reliability and advanced capabilities, along with U.S. air superiority strategies, suggest that China's fighter still falls short in dominating the skies. On paper, the J-20 has some advantages, while the F-22 boasts others. Practically, however, as General Kenneth Wilsbach, head of U.S. Air Forces Pacific, said, "I don't think that the J-20 is a dominating aircraft at this point, compared to what we have." While the Chinese aerospace industry is undoubtedly making great strides in producing advanced aircraft, the U.S. still has the advantage. While the Raptor is seriously lethal, as the Air Force's top air superiority platform, the Raptor possesses the stealth, speed, and power that wows aviation buffs and military experts alike. The Air Force is making moves to retire its remaining F-22 fleet down the line in order to allocate resources and manpower to its sixth-generation program. However, NGAD is currently on pause, and the service's F-22 fleet provides critical capabilities that will be required if a full-blown war with China arises in the imminent future. The F-22 Raptor is still being enhanced to retain an edge over newer near peers. As the Air Force's top air superiority platform, the jets have recently secured an infrared threat detection sensor upgrade that will bolster its lethality in the modern threat climate. Collectively known as the Infrared Defense System, IRDS, these Lockheed Martin-designed sensors will elevate the Raptors to be on par with the modern F/A-18 Super Hornet and F-35 Lightning II platforms. As explained by Lockheed Martin Mission Systems Vice President Hank Tucker, "We, Lockheed, understand the need for advanced and versatile infrared systems like IRDS that will make pilots' missions more survivable and lethal against current and future adversaries. We're committed to supporting the Air Force through continuous innovation of capabilities to deter and defeat evolving threats." Two new Chinese aircraft recently broke cover for the first time, demonstrating a significant leap ahead of current Chinese stealth technology and raising concerns about the future of American air superiority. The larger of these two aircraft, dubbed the J-36 by the media, boasts a stealthy Delta Diamond wing configuration with no standing vertical tail surfaces, allowing for both a massive increase of internal volume for larger fuel stores and payloads, and a significantly reduced radar return across different broadcast bands and angles of observation. For many, this new aircraft seemed to suggest that China's rapid military modernization efforts had now matured to the point of surpassing American low-observable technology. They further drew comparisons between this new stealth aircraft and the tailless renders we've seen depicting America's own next-generation stealth fighter, now a full decade into development, but currently halted due to budgetary shortfalls. Because as groundbreaking as China's new tailless stealth fighters may genuinely be for China, the concepts and technology informing their design largely aren't. More than a quarter century ago, before the F-22 had even entered service, Lockheed Martin was already designing stealth aircraft based on the soon-to-be legendary Raptor that demonstrated vital aspects of China's new stealth jet's design. When the Raptor first took to the skies in the early 2000s, it was truly unmatched, as it represented the first fifth-generation fighter to ever fly. The formidable platform was created as a result from the Air Force's Advanced Tactical Fighter Program in the Cold War era as a means to combat new aerial threats that were emerging at the time. Equipped with a tiny radar cross-section, the F-22 is roughly 5 to 10 times less observable than its F-35 Lightning II successor. This incredible attribute is best described by former Raptor pilot, Lieutenant Colonel Kevin Showtime Shutterfield, who has recounted how he was able to take his F-22 right up to an Iranian fighter entirely undetected during an incident back in 2013. As detailed by Shutterfield, he flew below the adversarial jet to inspect its weapon load and then pulled up alongside it to infamously warn its pilot, "You really ought to go home." In addition to its unparalleled stealth, the Raptor can pack a punch. The fifth-generation jet is equipped with three internal weapons bays that can carry two AIM-9 Sidewinder air-to-air missiles and six AIM-120 AMRAAM radar-guided air-to-air missiles. The fighter can also lug two GBU-32 JDAMs, or eight 250-pound small-diameter bombs, when flying in close air support or precision strike missions. But the F-22 could have been much more capable than the jet we ultimately got. During the Raptor's path to service, several capabilities that would have made the most dominant fighter of our time even better were whittled away from production plans in an effort to bring costs down amid America's transition toward the asymmetric conflicts of the global war on terror. Some of these capabilities are only now finding their way into the F-22 line, thanks to an ongoing nearly $11 billion upgrade that'll see roughly $72.6 million invested into each of 150 or so operational Raptors. For context, that means each F-22 will receive upgrades nearly comparable in cost to fielding an entirely new F-35A, including infrared search and track targeting capabilities and helmet-mounted displays, both systems that were originally intended to reach service with the first jets to roll off the production line in 1997, but will now likely be in use fleet-wide by 2029. Other capabilities that were cut are unlikely to ever see service, like side-mounted radar apertures that would have given the F-22 a significant boost in situational awareness, intelligence-gathering capabilities, and perhaps most importantly, targeting. The F-22's ANAPG-77 active electronically scanned array radar was, hands down, the most powerful targeting array ever affixed to a fighter at the time, but additional sideways-looking arrays would have allowed the F-22 to fly perpendicular to contest airspace while peering deep inside, mapping the locations of adversary assets, and even locking onto targets if needed. Two-seat F-22 Raptors that could operate alongside the single-seat iteration were also a part of the original production plan, but ultimately scrapped. It's incredible to think of what the F-22 Raptor could have been had it entered service with these additional capabilities two decades ago, considering the platform went on to become so dominant for so long without them. In fact, with the addition of IRST, helmet-cued targeting, and new stealthy external fuel tanks to extend the Raptor's range, there's a reasonable argument to be made that it will remain the most dominant fighter in the sky for years to come, as Russia's Su-57 and China's J-20 both still fall short of the F-22's combination of stealth, sensor fusion, and brute force performance, despite emerging more than a decade later. But even as the first F-22 test pilots were just beginning to put the production Raptor through its paces, Lockheed Martin was already looking ahead to other mission sets and other threats the Raptor could take on, in much the same way McDonnell Douglas found continued success with its Eagle line by modifying the F-15 for interdiction bombing duties in the F-15E Strike Eagle, while seemingly also pulling from the Strike Eagle's own highly capable competition in the FE-16XL. In our analysis of China's recently revealed J-36 stealth aircraft, we discussed how similar the center fuselage and payload bay portions of the new jet were to its Chengdu-designed sibling, the J-20 Mighty Dragon, though stretched to some extent for larger internal payloads, a design approach we compared to the F-16XL concept at the time, but admittedly, might be better compared to Lockheed Martin's FB-22. Like the J-20, the F-22's design focus was the air superiority mission. But like all modern fighters, these are truly multi-role platforms with mature, though perhaps limited, air-to-ground strike capabilities. In fact, for some time, the Raptor was commonly referred to as the FA-22 for this very reason. But by looking at this aircraft through the lens of aviation history, we can clearly see the parallels between China's new stealth aircraft and American efforts that were shelved two decades ago in favor of freeing up funding for the global war on terror. And now, As China continues to mature their aircraft toward service, the United States will need to look back into its own bag of tricks to find the most effective way to counter this burgeoning capability. If you enjoy content like this, please go ahead and like and subscribe to this video, because I appreciate all your support.